Well, we've been working on the porch.
I know. It looks like a lot of progress.
Well, you remember when Jonathan and I were out here working on the siding?
Mm-hmm.
We ran into a lot of rot. Had a lot of damage from carpenter ants. And so we've cleaned all that out, jacked it up, supported it. Coming back in with this new beam, structurally, the porch will be sound, and then we can start working up with the new railing.
And the pretty.
The pretty can happen then.
All we can do is put one more tube of six right here, and the beam will be secure.
Awesome. Okay, what's the story on the back porch?
It looks real nice.
Yeah.
Some issues, small issues on the back porch.
You can tell walking on it, it's a little spongy.
So that's why it was covered up with plywood.
That was their fix.
It's kind of rotten, kind of patchy.
Like a patchwork.
It is a wooden patchwork quilt of porch. Does this mean we're gonna have to pull up all this flooring and none of it's salvageable?
Well, it's all too short anyway.
That's true.
It's gotta run out to that post.
Okay, well, that's not a huge area. How expensive?
I mean, less than $1,000.
What were we wanting to build for back here?
A potting table.
Just like for gardening and stuff.
Yeah.
What if I use some of this to build it?
Yeah, well, I say go for it.
Let's work on getting some of it up. All right, I'm gonna haul this to the shop. I say this all the time. When opportunity knocks, you better answer that door. Luke is really into gardening. He talked about it a lot. Let's make some lemonade here. We're gonna take the flooring. We're gonna make him a garden bench. We need to get it all planed on both sides. I'm gonna work ripping some of it on the table saw. We've got these cedar 2x4s for the legs. All right, I'm gonna start assembling. And I'm attaching my rails to the legs. Then we'll start putting the slats on it. A couple screws each. A normal garden bench has a slatted area and then it's like a dry sink, just like a wooden box built into the cabinet. But I thought, why not make him something that he could pull out and walk out to the garden, set plants in it. So I made a tray, but I'm not actually going to put that much support underneath it. I'm gonna put a piece across here, and that's what the handles will actually rest on. And then I'm gonna do a shelf across the top, a little bit of polyurethane, and this thing's ready to go. It's not bad for a busted up porch. Just a couple hours ago, I was walking around on this.
This is the coolest stove. I told you. How fine is this stove?
I love it.
Oh, this is what I want for Luke's kitchen.
Does it work?
Well, no.
You want an old-looking stove.
It's the inspiration. Like, look how this is like a cook's kitchen. But it doesn't feel like Luke. It doesn't feel like his kitchen. It's a little bit sleek. Mm-hmm. That's definitely too modern. Stainless would work. I just saw something else in my mind's eye, and it was enameled. This is what I was hoping to find.
Yes.
It would be so perfect.
But how much is it?
It's basically free. Because we've saved so much money in the house. Mm-hmm. We repurposed the siding to make the beam in the ceiling. We reused the cabinetry.
I like your rationale.
Like, I'm leaving with this stove. Like, I don't know what else to tell you.
But I think it's the right one.
I have to have it, so.
Okay. What else do we need?
We need an refrigerator.
Okay.
It's a beautiful day to work outside.
Well, it's raining again.
More rain.
Nothing like moving in heavy, slick stone in the rain.
I love that. I like the color of a marshmallow. I'm always waiting for that awful sound. Looking good.
Can you imagine? He's basically been renting his whole adult life. And now this is gonna be his kitchen.
Oh, it's gonna be, I mean, like a chef's kitchen.
You think he can cook some good rutabagas?
Maybe. Rutabagas?
I can't wait for him to see it.
I know, I can't wait either.
Welcome to the Ponder House.
Oh, wow. That is amazing. That's not even the same house.
It's your house.
Doesn't look like the one I bought. It does not.
I don't know what to say. It's just, I'm speechless, which is highly unusual, by the way. But I mean, the porch is just perfect. It couldn't be better.
The landscaping, I think, made a huge difference.
Yeah, you can see the house. It's got paint on it and not peeling paint.
Yeah.
It's got color.
You can see the color, right?
Some of it. It's several shades of gray.
Aww. Well, do you want to go take a look inside?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
All right.
Is this the screen porch of your dreams?
This is it. This is it. This is what I imagined. Mosquitoes out here, Luke in here.
Yeah.
There you go.
And you got a knee breeze.
I mean, hello.
Yes.
Which
yes,
I know you've
yes.
been waiting for.
I need a knee breeze. I'm going to lose a lot of good work out here.
There you
I
go.
I just want y'all to know that.
Yeah, well, the porch is swell, but I'm dying to show you inside.
That sounds wonderful.
I can't wait.
Oh, man. This is amazing. See my old wooden sports stuff?
Well, I thought they were beautiful, and it was a perfect way to tell some of your story.
This looks like home.
So yeah, this room was a breeze. It was paint.
Right.
And
this was the easy room.
It really brightened it up in here, and it makes it feel twice as large almost. Yeah, I love it.
This next room is really special.
We're putting more and more love in each room as we go along.
Okay. Man, it's just, oh.
What do you think?
I am so glad we did not make a dining room out of this space.
Yeah.
This is perfect. This is what I wanted. Somehow they read my mind, I guess.
Obviously, the built-ins dominate the room.
Your books can breathe again.
Yeah, and they have been in boxes for so long.
This is the U room.
This is. This is where I'm going to come. I'm going to relax.
Well, speaking of U time, you haven't had a proper kitchen.
Proper kitchen's been a long time, so.
You've got one now.
We wanted to spoil you a little bit.
Wow. Amazing. Amazing. Man, this is a kitchen. Oh, my goodness.
This is the finest oven that I have ever seen.
It's beautiful.
And your refrigerator matches it. It's a set.
Oh.
Yep.
And the way y'all wrap the cabinets around it, it's just amazing.
Yep, you didn't really? Have any storage over there. And this is the thing I really love about your kitchen.
Right.
This is the original cabinetry and your original doors and hardware. And then this is an exact replication.
Yeah,
of
that,
it.
That matched up beautifully.
And then your pantry door, we took a door from the hallway.
Okay.
And then frosted it and put it there so you have more sunlight in your kitchen.
Oh, man.
How about that?
This is beautiful. I want to kick everybody out and start cooking.
I know.
I gained 10 pounds just looking at what I could cook in there.
And on the other side of that French door is the last little thing we want to show you.
Okay.
A little more love out here on the back porch.
Now, I love this.
So this porch was actually in a little worse shape than we were expecting. We pulled all of the flooring up, and that's what I built your potting bench out of.
This is beautiful. It's the work porch then.
This is your work porch.
Work off some of those pounds I'm gonna put on in the kitchen in the backyard.
So you got the McRae house for $36,000.
Right.
Your all-in budget was $100,000.
Right.
We stayed just under that. Everything you saw, plus new plumbing, new electrical.
That's value.
That
is
huge.
Value. I'm just so pleased with the way everything fits me. The front porch is perfect for me. The study's perfect for me. The living room's perfect for me. That kitchen. I'm trying to choose which room I'm going to die in at the end of my life, you know?
The thing is, you really haven't seen the house the way we can see the house, so we got you glasses that correct color blindness.
Oh, that is amazing. You honestly would not believe the difference. Thank you so much. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Heck yeah.
It was a nice house. Now it's a home. Now it looks like somebody belongs there. Now it looks like I belong there.